How's it going, guys? Clutch here once again. We're over in Ravenport right now. We got a bit of a cryptic message from Bob and Dino. Who the heck are those guys? I guess they were actually the ones that stopped by to pick up DJ's trucks the other day. And they figure that we owe him payment now? Oops, go this way here. I don't know why they figure that we had to pay them. That didn't make any sense at all to me. So they're pretty upset with us. I mean, to be honest, I thought they were like some mobsters. I don't know. Yeah, up here. Oh, coming? All right. So anyways, we decided we'd better come over to Ravenport and talk to DJ and see if we can kind of clear this up ourselves, because it's a bit of a disaster. These guys are turning into kind of hotheads, and you know what? I don't want to be part of that. I know his farm. He's got his farm all set up here somewhere now. Let's go see if he's down there. Now, their message was pretty cryptic, so I don't know what the heck they're talking about. Ah, it's down there. Look at that. He's got stuff all set up down there. Let's go take a look. Holy, that's quite the operation he's got down here. This Goham Co. is going off. Look at this. Now, I know he kept his trucks down here. Were they not down here before? He's got all his equipment down here. A lot of equipment. I don't see his trucks in, and there's nobody down here. At all.
Well, since nothing's going on down here, the only thing else on this note is that they want to meet us at the beach. I wish DJ was around so we could come take care of this. Alright, well, I guess I better head down to the beach to meet these guys and see if we can fix this up. I don't think I should have to be giving them any money, mind you. I mean, this is DJ's thing.
I don't know. I mean, I don't think I should have to pay these guys. So, I don't know. Maybe DJ wants to pay them for their services finally. But, I mean, it was all just gifts, right? I mean, I appreciate the gifts, but I'm not going to pay for someone to... I don't know. Yeah, it doesn't make any sense to me. So, how do you get to the beach here? Anyone know? It's not like I come here to go to the beach very often. I think I see water. Okay. Looks like we should be able to kind of cut down over here. This looks all right. Tracks. Oh, there's a little path right there. That looks all right. Let's try this. Oh, watch out. Sorry. Coming through. Yep. Don't want to get down to the beach, see what's going on down here. Oh, this is a nice little spot. I don't know if I was supposed to be driving down here or not, but it looks like we got somebody's parked down at the end over there. Let's go take a look. Maybe that's Bob and Dino. Yeah, maybe they're just hanging out and having a few wobbly pops. I don't know. Wait a minute. That doesn't quite look right. It does look like DJ's trucks, but no. Oh no, DJ is not going to be happy. Apparently they parked it in the ocean and the tide came in, and wow, that's a bit of an issue. DJ, I am so sorry. I am so sorry. I don't know if you're going to want to drive these trucks anymore. They look a little full of sand, and I'm sure water and everything else that's gotten into them. Oh dude, that sucks. I shouldn't be laughing, but it's kind of funny. Wow, that's crazy. I'm gonna leave these here. I'll let DJ deal with that. I mean, they're registered to him, right? Let's get out of here.
Clutch Simulations.
Hey guys, welcome back to Felsbrunn. It's been a couple days. We've got a bunch of stuff to take care of today. A little bit of animal tending too, I think, is going to be our focus for the day. This is our new road. Look at this. Got a little bit of work to it. It's looking pretty good. Not as smooth as I'd like to get it, but hey, a little dirt road, that's okay. So we got our animals. We got two horses we need to sell off again. So let's go and pick up our horse trailer and get to work. I guess I could have went around the other way. There she is.
Perfect. Let's go.
That'll be good. That'll make us another 100 grand, which is always good. And we'll go buy another two horses again. This is kind of an easy money-making scheme for us, to be honest. This is working out really, really well. Which ones are most expensive? There we go. We'll go with, we'll get rid of him and them. And confirm. Perfect. And, all right, let's head over to the animal sell point area. And we will sell these horses off and pick up two new ones. So that's a pretty good little profit for the day. Oh, bump, 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 bump. All right, so we'll head over there. After we get this finished up, we do have... Oh, I didn't even know you could put the tarp into that. That's kind of cool. Get around that corner. We do need to start taking care of our cows, and I wouldn't mind selling some of the milk, seeing what kind of profit we're making off that. Now, we haven't really been dealing with any food for that yet, so that's kind of... it's on my mind for sure. The food's been lasting quite a while, but they've only making... What is it? We have the middle-range food, the hay and silage. We're not making the TMR right now, so that's going to have to change. Ooh, let's get this all fixed up. Perfect. Sell them off. And we need to confirm. Perfect. So we made 100 grand almost off that. Oops. And now let's buy another couple horses. Horse. We'll get a black one. And we don't think we have a Palomino right now, so we'll go with those two. Confirm. Fantastic. All right, so we will need to work on those horses. Obviously, they are fresh. They need to be trained. A lot of time over in the riding arena, that's for sure. Now, I wish the riding arena would actually like help you build them up a little faster. You know what I mean? Like, instead of taking so long per horse, if you could use the riding arena, that would be great. It would, like, make things go a little bit quicker because they get trained faster. I don't know. It'd be kind of a cool idea. We'll zip through there. And back through the bumps. bump. I can't find a way of getting that much smoother than that. I don't know. Maybe one bump would be better than having like six. drop these guys off. Boom. And confirm. All right, so we are back up to 8 horses. Looks good. Looks really good. I do love having horses on the ranch now. This is so cool. And they're actually pretty profitable. It's not bad once you get everything kind of going. And there's no maintenance, really. It's just some food, which isn't such a big deal, which is kind of cool. Anyways, cows, on the other hand, let's go check on the cows. you dirty buggers. See what I mean? This is not talking about maintenance. Like, always have to clean up after these buggers. Let's see what they're at. Yeah, 17%. Of course. Yeah, of course you are. All right, well, you know what that means. We need to go take care of that. See, with horses, yeah, you just kind of... I mean, you got to walk them, I guess, and run them out every day, but I don't know. I guess you have to remember that. It's a lot of work, too. Boom. Let's get the old Lintrac out. I need a bucket. Now, the other problem I know I'm going to have is that I think I just saw the cow's troughs are full of silage and hay, which is what this ends up being when you go to pick it up. So usually what I like to do is just pick it up and dump it right back into their food trough and they can eat their mess back up. But that is not going to be an option today. Yeah, of course not. Let me just double check here. Yeah, hay and silage is that. Let's see. I'll try and dump some. Well, I've got some in my bucket right now, actually. I forgot I had that from last time. I couldn't get rid of it. So I got 413. I don't know if that's in liters. I don't know, whatever that is. But watch. We'll dump a little bit. No. Or not. Yeah, now it's full. The trough is full. So I need to find a better place to dump this.
If I get my camera working ideally, that would be great too. Alright. Oh, and that's as full as she gets. Oh. I haven't had that happen in 19 yet. Where your bucket kind of lifts everything up. You know what? I'm just going to put this kind of over here and beside it. And we'll use that for food later on. I mean, I could take it up and put it in the woods. And I'd be like, eh. No one saw me do that. I think as long as it's out of the food trough area, it won't count. And then I can use this later on as more food. Because I'm cheap. Come on. Nope, not picking it up. Come on. There we go. Come on. Got it straightened out. We'll try this again. Okay. All right. We got it all. All right. So that takes care of that. Now, we also have a few other things going on with the cows. Oh. I know we're making quite a bit of slurry. Let's just sneak around back here. I'll zoom us out a bit. Yeah, we're making quite a bit of slurry. I could probably sell that. And we've also got a decent amount of manure. Well, some manure. Not that much. Half a trailer full, I guess. We could probably sell that as well. But I'll save that up, I think, for another day. However, I think the milk is getting to the point where we need to think about that. So, you know what? Let's head over to the shop. I've already kind of made a little bit of a purchase for us. And that should be good. Get in here and drop this bucket off so we can use it again next time. This one. Perfect. Awesome. All right. So, yeah, we'll head down to the shop. Now, I'm pretty sure that this truck will be perfect for the trailer I've got us. I was on the fence a little bit on how I was going to do this. And to be perfectly honest, I have not done any milk yet in FS19 other than just messing around with it in one of my tutorial stuff. So I wanted to definitely get involved, make a bit of money on it. Now, to be perfectly clear and honest, I did not really think that you made that much money off milk. It was a little bit weak. Ooh, I did not buy the trailer yet. But I did. Oh well, you know what? That's what we're here for. Alright. You know what? We'll just pull right into the shop so we can spin around. Alright. Alright, so now what I need is it's in trailers and animals. Boom. Alright, so now I'm sure we could probably do with this trailer here would actually be able to carry milk, but I want a proper one. Oh no, I can't. I thought you could do that one with milk, but it cannot. So we'll do the small one. It's a $40,000 difference. I don't have anything that can drive this trailer yet. I don't have a semi truck. Yep. We'll go with chrome. I like the chrome look, but, like all the trucks, you're starting at $100,000, it seems like. Oh, well, you can get the 74, I suppose, which is a mod truck for 25 grand. Maybe we'll do that at some point. But, yeah, this one here, it's 8,000 liters, which is roughly what we currently have in our stockpile. And I can tow it with this farm truck. I mean, it sounds perfect to me. Boom. Actually, no, I gotta get the lights on. There we go. Alright. So I also did find a no collision mod, camera collision mod, and it seems to be working a little bit better so far. Finally. I mean, that's been something I've been waiting for. Now I need to try it with some of the other things. Stuff in the back. I wonder if that would fix our problem there too. Alright, so for the milk, let's see here. Now, you can see what happened to my road here when I built this shed. They kind of built it up onto the road. I'm sure the the council up to the town here would be really happy with me for doing that. Up we go. See, I was always under the assumption that that little trailer could actually handle milk, but I guess not. Anyways, alright. That's okay. That's why we got this trailer. I'm close enough there. I am. 8,900 liters. Our trailer holds 8,000, so we're still going to have almost 1,000 liters left over. That's not bad. Hey, cows. Hey, guys. Let's take a look here. Now, where's the best price for our milk? Let's zoom over. Boom, there's the milk. So 12, 17 grain mill, 18 port southeast. Well, that sounds like a no-brainer. Our port southeast is way down over here. That's not too far. Where's the grain mill? Oh, the grain mill's right in the middle there. That's all right. And the sawmill's up top. You know what? I've never done anything to this railroad silo east yet. Everything's always been down at this one or this one, it seems like. Actually, the train station mill too. But yeah, nothing way up at the railroad silo east. Anyways, let's go drop off the milky milk. Milk! Yeah, let's get out of this little area here. I still need to organize those bales. Man, I've been lazy lately. There's too much going on. Yeah. Cool. All right, so I'm going to zip over there. I'll meet you guys down at the silo there, and we'll see how much we get out of this thing. So I'll meet you guys down there. All right, let's go. All right, so pretty quick little drive, and here is the silo I'm looking for. Get our signal on. Oh, that's a sharp turn. Oh. Now, I was talking to Farmer Min about this particular truck, and it's not bad with this type of a trailer. But that using that gooseneck, if you're going at all at any kind of a speed, you can flip this thing no problem. And it is not easy to get back on its wheels. Right, let's see. What do you guys think we're going to get here? Fire away. My bet, 8,000. I would bet we're going to be just over 15 grand. That would be my rough guess, I would think, on 8,000 liters. But, yeah, it seems like it's a decent amount of money for that. I mean, we don't have to do a lot of work. It's just a lot of food. And once we're set up now, it shouldn't be about 15,086. Oh, wow. How do you like that for a guess? So that's not bad. 15 grand for, well, it's a little bit of work. It's, I don't know. I'd rather do a crop, I think. But it's kind of a byproduct of doing crops at the same time for me, because you're going to be left over with all this food potentially, or the a lot of the grain. And what do you think? Is it more worthwhile to sell like the straw and everything else and the food rather than use it for cattle, or does it multiply when you're making, when you have cattle? I don't know. Like for 15, that doesn't seem like it's all that much money in the grand scheme of things for what we had to do there. Yeah. Anyways, speaking of which, we've got a little bit more work to do with these cows, so I'll meet you guys back over at the farm. All right, so back at the old farm, the old ranch, horse ranch. I know our cows and our horses could probably use a little bit of water. It won't be too much, but it'll be enough that I should definitely consider doing it. So here we go. Now I'm pretty sure I filled this up. Yeah, I did too. Perfect. So it's all ready to rock and roll. Rock and roll. Let's start with our horses since we're right here, and I'm sure they'll take a lot less. Boom. Yeah, they only took like 100 and what was that? No, 1,000 liters, I guess. 1,000? 7,300, I think, is full. Perfect. Let's fill this back up before we go. Now the cows, I bet, will take a lot more. I bet you it'll be almost this full container. Now I'm not sure if there's an easier way to do this yet. I think this is probably the best bet for me. I know in some of the maps in 17 you could like have a trough. You could pay to have a trough and a water supply that just constantly fills the trough. It'd be like an extra 5 grand. It would cost you $35 a day or something along those lines. But for right now, yeah, we are empty. How much did we get there? We got approximately, oh yeah, we're almost full. Okay, so just a little bit more and we'll be good to go there.
All right, so that'll do it for the water. The only thing I've got left is I need to put some straw in the cattle pen or the cattle yard there. So we'll drop this off. You know what? I'll start filling it up, and I think it'll fill as well once I drop it. I can just go. We'll leave it right in here so it's kind of out of the way. And I should be able to leave it there, and I think it'll fill even without me doing anything with it. But, yeah, we need to get the straw into that pen. Boom. So, in order to get the straw in there, we'll just have to take our tractor over and do it the right way, I suppose. You know what? I bet you I could hook my truck up to that, but it's not... There's something weird with that. I mean, it's not... It's a PTO-driven device, and I can hook up anything I want to it. For instance, you'll see I've got a weight on the back here. There should be no way I should be able to hook into this machine, because you can see that big yellow bar. That's the PTO that's supposed to go in and hook up and essentially drive this device. But I can hook up to it, and the pipe goes right through my weight. Yeah, exactly. That shouldn't happen. So we'll drop the weight beside it just for prosperity or prosperity's sakes. Right there. And I always forget the back wheels turn on this. It always kind of sets me up a little bit. I need to get used to that. All right, so that's that. Why is it not giving me... Oh, there it is. Never mind. And we'll set it out. Look at that. We'll just nail that cow with all this straw. We got a full bale back there, it looks like. See, this is another problem for me, is this bale always looks full, no matter how much is there. As long as there's some bale or some of it there, you're gonna see a full bale inside this thing. And so you could be driving by like, oh yeah, I got a full bale, I just have to go up there and hook the tractor up to it. Meanwhile, you've got like 10 units. Hey buddy, what's going on? That's too funny. Just hanging out, just getting my straw bath. That's all right. Cool. All right, so that is that, and that is going to do us for today, guys. Just before we go, do make sure you go check out DJ Goham Gaming's channel if you want to keep tabs on the storyline. He's got some awesome farming, some stuff going on over there as well. So do definitely go check out DJ Goham Gaming. His link is down in the description below, along with some other cool creators you guys may be interested in. Go check them all out. And other than that, guys, that's going to do it for us here today in Fellsprun. So if you did like this video, well, make sure you hit that thumbs up button, guys. And of course, if you are not a subscriber, well, you know what to do. I don't need to tell you that. Do I? Nah, we'll leave it for next time. Anyways, guys, that's going to do it for me. This is Clutch, over and out.